right, so here he is, one of the more prolific takedown artists in the UFC at present. And when you get some praise from Daniel Cormier when it comes to your offensive takedown game, you know you're doing something right.
And we talk about wrestlers and judo players and grapplers, but this guy just combines all of that. He is able to use foot sweeps from the grappling game. He is able to use throws from judo, and he's able to use wrestling from the wrestling game to take people down. He has an array of takedowns at his disposal, and he uses every single one of them, from the speed of the level change to the timing to the knowledge of where to go next. When the guy starts to defend, he's truly, truly something special.
I don't think he could take you down, but tonight he doesn't have to. So
he does not
in
have
this
to.
Matchup, prevailing wisdom is he'll be able to get this fight to the canvas. All right, so here he is, DC, the one, the only Tony Ferguson, the former UFC interim lightweight champion and the man who was the first to accrue a double-digit winning streak in the division, 155 pounds, that most people believe is the best and deepest in the UFC.
It has long been the deepest division in the UFC, and Tony Ferguson has maneuvered his way through that and had eventually captured the interim lightweight championship. One of the most diverse strikers that you've ever seen. I mean, the elbow he hit against Josh Thompson to split him open was unbelievable. And couple that with the college wrestling background,
right,
and every time you step into the octagon with Ferguson, you know you're going to have your hands full. From him walking to the octagon dancing to getting in there and being so free-flowing, Tony Ferguson is one of the best fighters on the UFC's roster.
He really thrives under the bright lights. He is a finisher of the highest order. His training habits are truly the stuff of legend. Eddie Bravo talks about this guy training for 6 hours straight.
Oh.
Probably ill-advised for most fighters, but El Kukui can do it.
He can do it.
Ladies and gentlemen, this fight is 3 rounds in the UFC lightweight division. Introducing first, fighting out of the blue corner. This man is a mixed martial artist, holding a professional record of 23 wins, 8 losses. He stands 5 feet 8 inches tall, weighing in at 155 pounds. Fighting out of Boca Raton, Florida, Iron Michael Chandler! And now introducing his opponent, fighting out of the red corner. This man is a freestyle fighter, holding a professional record of 26 wins, 8 losses. He stands 5 feet 11 inches tall, weighing in at 155 pounds. Fighting out of Orange County, California, and when the action begins, our referee in charge, Dan Mergliotta.
So Dan Mergliotta shares the cage. So the fight is now underway. We'll see how long it goes. We've got a submission specialist on one side and on the other side, maybe the most well-rounded fighter in this fight.
Yeah, he is one of the best fighters in the entire UFC. But in front of him, he has one of the most dangerous fighters across all divisions in the octagon. Because that one skill he has is so good that you're in danger the entire time.
Well, we told you off the top he had the reach advantage, and you saw it right there with that punch. Well, perhaps a sign of things to come as he lands a kick there.
Nice kick landed by the cover. That's a big strike right there.
Well, he's doing a nice job here blocking these shots. The chin is tucked, the hands are high. Pretty good job defensively thus far.
Great job defensively. He's seeing everything coming. Look at him chopping the wood. Chop the wood with his leg kick.
Splits the guard, lands the right hand. Oh, nice offering there by Tony Ferguson. We'll see if he can follow it up here, champ.
I mean, he usually does. He does not let guys off the hook. Tony Ferguson is a guy that has a killer's mindset. And when he gets you hurt, he's looking to finish. Oh, nice jab.
Throws the body with the knee. Oh!
Big punch lands through the middle.
Was able to get that right hand over the top and to the target. Oh, that is a nice straight punch by him there. He's got it all going tonight.
No wasted actions, no loopy punches. He's going right to the target.
Misses with that punch.
Look at how he turns his hip into that leg kick.
Under 2 minutes to go. Continues to mix it up, going to the head, mixing in some body shots. Oh, connects with the 1-2. All right, so he lands another jab now, just snapping that thing off, DC.
I believe that the jab was lost in mixed martial arts initially, but now it has been found, and it's been found by this young man in this octagon tonight.
Keeps going back to that jab, keeps throwing that jab, but unable to land.
The biggest shot that he's landed all night. A massive uppercut land.
Massive head kick. Absorbing those strikes quite well.
That one was thrown to end the fight.
Yep. Oh, big left hand.
What an ambulance blowing up.
He knows you're going to come hard, so he's going to be ready.
All right, so there's the end of the round. He stayed committed to doing damage upstairs and landed a seminal blow in that round.
It was accumulation of those strikes. He kept hitting him over and over to the head. Eventually, he found the one that really did damage his opponent.
Nice job to land the straight punch there. Must be nice to have that kind of reach advantage, DC. I know you can't necessarily relate. A swing and a miss by Ferguson. He can truly do it all. Connects with a right. Well, he's certainly keeping busy, DC, connecting with most of the punches he's thrown.
I mean, punches in bunches. He's doing a great job. Good punch. Oh!
They continue to exchange. Watch the punch. Just out of range with that left hook.
Nice kick.
Trying to establish that jab. Oh, nice pop there from the crowd as he finally gets the takedown. He stayed committed to the offensive wrestling, and now he has his...
Oh, is he an active pursuer of the submission?
This is tight. Goodness, what a fight.
Yeah, that is high-level grappling right there as he gets the win tonight here by way of submission, and he bided his time there. He stayed patient, waited for an opening, and then when it was there, he certainly capitalized to get the tap here tonight. Well, let's take a look back at the replay as he gets it done by submission tonight, champ.
Just watch how slowly he approaches the submission, though. He never rushes. He takes his time, but it's his trickiness. It's his ability to trick people into going to the floor with him that puts them in danger and finishing fights.
So there he is, your winner by submission, and that's exactly how you put the rest of this division on notice. Looks like this guy could be a factor moving forward in this division.
Ladies and gentlemen, referee Dan Mergliotta has called a stop to this contest at 2 minutes, 11 seconds of round number 2. Declaring the winner by tap out, Tony El Capri Ferguson!
Well, what an incredible result here tonight as you see the winner there celebrating his victory by way of submission. And they put so much stock into finishing this fight. They felt like to really spin his career forward, they needed to not just win but get the finish, and they certainly got it tonight.
They got the finish. He's such a terrific grappler. Every time he's on his back, he looks for submissions over and over again. Eventually, he found one tonight and got the desired result.
I'm not gonna lie. We gon' march in the party. Get the out of my way. Thunder got kicked like karate. Go on to meet the AK. Look at me, 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 look at me now.
You ready?
So here we go, round one. I can barely hear myself think in this arena right now. Two of the most dominant, well-rounded fighters in this division.
I mean, these guys are the best of all of mixed martial arts. They can do everything when they're locked inside of the octagon. I'm so excited to watch the highest level of MMA on display tonight. Nice nuclear punch.
Advantage as he landed the jab there, DC. All right, then a left. Hook shot attempt to the head here. Instead, it's blocked by Caceres. Man, whoa!
What a fantastic strike to throw at the exact right moment. He deserves this moment. Go finish this fight. He's throwing every part of himself into these big leg kicks. He's a coach. He's hurt bad.
Oh, he might be out.
Good right here.
Oh, significant strike attempt there, but a huge block.
Going to the leg kick now, and it's there. Nice job by Caceres. Oh, stuffs the takedown without issue.
Look at how he turns his hip over when he throws that kick.
Oh!
Oh, he's hurt.
Oh! Back to the feet. Under 2 minutes to go in a back and forth first round here.
Big punch lands over the top. How's he gonna follow this one up?
Oh, he lands the Superman punch. How about it?
He loaded up that round too.
Stuffs the takedown, no problem. Oh, I love the jab. I know you love the jab. That was a nice one.
It's my favorite punch in all the fights. Gotta be careful dipping his head when he's throwing that jab.
Oh! Massive head kick there. We'll see if he can finish.
Big powerful punch lands. Now he gets back to range.
Checks the leg kick. Oh, beautiful counter with the jab. Round two next. All right, so there's the horn signifying the end of the round. We had a knockdown there, but not a knockout.
No, it wasn't a knockout, but you can't take those shots. That big punch landed, and it sat him down. If he gets hit with another one of those, it might be goodnight, Irene. There's no give on that leg kick.
Looking to land the right hand, he misses. Checks the leg kick. Ortega gets hit with a kick here. Let's see how he responds. Well, we talked about his reach advantage off the top. On the ground, DC, but you got to be very careful hanging out here for too long if you're his opponent. Working off of his back here, looks like he may try to hip escape. Might be a submission attempt here, champ.
I mean, you cannot sit in a full guard. When you sit in the full guard, you give these guys so many opportunities.
Bottom fighter trying to control posture, unable to do so.
And now he's in a lot of danger. He's got to grab that head, or he's going to get blasted.
All right, so he's got the body locked down here, DC, or so it appears. This is not a guy you want anywhere near your back. All right, so you got to be careful playing on the ground with this guy. You don't want to mess around for too long. Connects with a right hand. Pretty good punch, that one.
Nice right punch by this young man.
The ground and pound has been there all night. All right, side control now, DC. You know he's in his element on the ground. A lot of tricks up his sleeve.
A lot of tricks.
Just reached the midway point of the fight. Remaining active here in his pursuit of the submission. Another attempt here.
He's got his chin in, but now it's starting to slip under the neck. Look at him push the arm down, maybe stepping into a crucifix. Wow, you don't see that very often.
Oh, he's in trouble here. Determine who wins the bonuses, but when you execute an inverted triangle choke like that, 50 G.
Pay that man. Pay that man.
Right, let's take a look back at the replay as he gets it done by submission tonight, champ.
He does a great job of staying patient. He doesn't rush or panic. You are never safe when you're fighting this guy. You're in a lot of trouble. You're in a lot of trouble the entire time when you're this good in the submissions.
So there he is, your winner by submission tonight, and that is how you put the rest of the division on notice. A huge result for him here tonight.
Ladies and gentlemen, referee Eve Levine has called a stop for this contest at 3:19 of round number 2. Declaring the winner by tap out due to a reverse triangle, Brian T. City Ortega!
All right, so there he is, all smiles, and rightfully so, after he gets the job done by submission tonight. You told me off the air before the fight that he was going to submit him, and that's exactly what happened.
I mean, you know, this guy has such a great submission game that you cannot lay in his guard. And his opponent is known to lay in the guard. He made him pay for it tonight, got the submission victory.
Charge me up and put gas in me. Them little fish wanna try a ting.